This tutorial shows you how to test for multicollinearity in a linear regression using SPSS. For context, for models with more than one predictor, multicollinearity describes a strong correlation between two or more predictors. Needless to say, you don't want that because your coefficients will be untrustworthy and the model cannot attribute an explanation of variance to the predictors. You have three possibilities to check for multicollinearity. A scatterplot matrix is an easy way to start, especially when you have only variables on an interval or ratio scale. Go through Graphs, Chart Builder, and select Scatter from the gallery, and then the Scatterplot matrix on the far right-hand side. Simply drag the relevant variables onto the graph. Note, the preview is always broken. In my example, only IQ and motivation can be added. When looking at the matrix, they show a considerable linear relationship, aka correlation. Time to investigate this further and also consider the gender and degree of participants within the second method. For a correlation table, go through Analyze, Correlate, Bivariate. Then put all your predictors into the Variables box. In case all your predictors are on an interval or ratio scale, or are dichotomous, you can use the pre-selected Pearson coefficient. If you have ordinal variables, select Spearman or Kendall's tau. For categorical variables with more than two values, you should use the respective dummies of them. As before, IQ and motivation are added. Furthermore, gender, which is dichotomous, as well as the degree, which has three values here. The majority of correlations shows small p-values, which is not a problem in itself. When looking at the correlation coefficients, however, one can see some considerable correlations. As expected from the scatterplot matrix, motivation is highly correlated with IQ, with 0.748. As well as no degree, minus 0.824, and master's degree. The absolute correlation coefficient is used for negative values. According to Field, a correlation above 0.8 or 0.9 gives rise to concern. If that is the case, you should weigh in whether the predictors essentially measure the same construct. In my example, I would still be fine with the correlations, especially since I would not see the same construct being measured by them. Finally, the third method allows for a very precise identification of potential sources for multicollinearity. Simply define your model within the linear regression dialog box. Then choose Statistics and select Collinearity Diagnostics. You will then get your usual regression output. A detailed video on its interpretation is linked in the description and pinned comment. Your focus this time is only on the coefficient table and its last two columns, which are added because we requested collinearity diagnostics. They show tolerance and VIF. 1 divided by tolerance equals VIF, and 1 divided by VIF equals tolerance. Usually, only VIF is interpreted, the so-called variance inflation factor. Higher values indicate that this predictor could be a problematic source in regard to multicollinearity. In my case, motivation has a value of 8.1, and the master's degree of 9.1. A very conservative approach states that the values should not exceed 2. However, in reality, higher values can be tolerated. If you have values above 10, this should concern you. A predictor with such a high value very likely measures something similar or the same as another predictor. Despite the VIF values being high in my example, they are still acceptable, since for this context, a higher correlation between my predictors is somewhat expected. Please be aware that excluding predictors simply by looking at the VIF values is not sufficient. It is a diagnostic tool, and any changes you make to your model, especially the predictors, should be backed up by arguments and made completely transparent.